Hello, I'm Dr. Azal from Medicovisual.com, and in today's visual lecture, we will talk about weight map during the gastrulation process. As we have discussed previously in the lecture of somitogenesis and changes in the intraembryonic mesoderm, that if we peel off this ectodermal layer of the embryo, the intraembryonic mesoderm will be revealed. Now, what we have discussed already, that this intraembryonic mesoderm, it is not a single homogeneous undifferentiated layer. Instead, it consists of different parts, and those parts are, here is the neural tube and notochord. This neural tube, of course, is not the part of intraembryonic mesoderm, but just remember that it is there. And along with that, this is the notochord, which is also called axial mesoderm. And then we have paraxial mesoderm, which runs parallel to this axial mesoderm but slightly laterally. And more lateral to paraxial mesoderm, the most lateral structure is the lateral plate mesoderm, and in between the paraxial and lateral plate mesoderm is the intermediate mesoderm. So what we have observed is that intraembryonic mesoderm consists of different components. Now, how these different components of intraembryonic mesoderm are formed? During the process of gastrulation, here is the ectoderm and here is the endoderm. And here I have made this ectoderm slightly transparent so you can see what happens. So during the process of gastrulation in third week, the cells that ingress downward from this primitive node or Hensen's node, they will form the notochord and precordal plate. And the cells that ingress downward from this primitive streak, they will form different components of intraembryonic mesoderm. They will form all those components, the paraxial mesoderm, the intermediate mesoderm, the lateral plate mesoderm, and even some contribution towards the extraembryonic mesoderm. Now let's see what happens. So here is the ectoderm, here is the endoderm, the primitive node and primitive streak. Let's make the endoderm transparent. And now first cells that go from this primitive node, they will form the precordal plate and the notochord. And now the cell that ingresses downward from the cranial most part, from the cranial most part of primitive streak and some caudolateral part of the primitive node, these cells that ingress from this point, they will form the paraxial mesoderm, right? Now the point to understand here is that the fate of these ingressing cells is determined by the location from which they ingress downward. For example, these cells that ingresses downward from the cranial part of the primitive streak, they will form the paraxial mesoderm. And then let's move forward. Here are those cells which ingress from the mid streak, from the middle part of the primitive streak, these cells will form the intermediate mesoderm. And then those cells which ingress from the caudal part of the primitive streak, they are going to form the lateral plate mesoderm. And finally, the cells that ingress from the caudal most part of this primitive streak, they will contribute towards the extraembryonic mesoderm. Now, extraembryonic mesoderm, it is thought to be formed from the hypoblast cells during third week of development. But there is also some contribution done by these ingressing cells in the third week of development. Now, what you can understand from this diagram is that the medial most component of the intraembryonic mesoderm, that is notochord here, it passes from the cranial most part of the primitive streak and primitive node, and lateral most part of this intraembryonic mesoderm, it is contributed by those cells that ingress from the caudal most part. For example, here you can see that the lateral most part is the lateral plate mesoderm, and it is contributed by those cells which ingress through the caudal most part of the primitive streak. So the primitive streak and primitive node, they are thought to be the real guiding stars during this process of gastrulation. Now, by the way, what is the extraembryonic mesoderm? We have already talked about extraembryonic mesoderm during the second week of development, but let's briefly reorient ourselves with the extraembryonic mesoderm. Now, you must be aware of the fact that this ectoderm, it continues dorsally with the amnion, right? And this endoderm, it continues ventrally with another balloon-like structure that is called yolk sac. So the embryo is provided with two balloons, the amnion and the yolk sac. And these two balloons, along with this embryo, hold this structure. It is plastered outside. It is surrounded outside by the extraembryonic mesoderm. So this is the extraembryonic mesoderm. So extraembryonic mesoderm, it is formed during the second week of development, and it is thought to be mainly formed by the hypoblast cell, but it is also contributed by the cells that ingress from the caudalmost part of the primitive streak. These cells, they also contribute to the extraembryonic mesoderm. So this was about the fate map during gastrulation. Thank you so much for watching this video.